After lighting a fuel tab to try to get a little bit of water boiled, I had a bit of a hard time and I remembered something that a friend of mine had showed me years ago. Basically, it'd make fuel pellets out of wax. It uses dryolint and wax. Now, you put a match sticking out of it, use some imagination, or you could put a match in the middle, and take a striker and then just strike it up. And it just makes it easy. The wax I used was terrible and the dryolint was terrible, but I haphazardly put a video together on it. This fuel tab should have been a little bit thinner, something you can actually break into pieces, probably about half or even quarter this thickness. You can take a spatula and push it in and make four little blocks that you can break off if you just need to start a fire, or if you want to roast something or boil water, you can use the whole block or part of it. So I used a pull container, and if you make them thin enough, you could probably get 5 or 6 fuel pellets in there. And that's not all I did though. A friend of mine showed me some neat little tricks, and I really should have had cling wrap to put on this to make a neater block when I pressed it. But what you can do is take matches or even a lighter and embed it inside the actual wax. So if the wax is still soft, you can use a spatula and push it in to the wax, like I said, so you can break it. The block's too thick to break. I thought it would be. So I just worked it on the side and broke it open sideways. You could probably make it half this thickness, get away with it, and still have matches and a striker on the inside. Not only is the wax block waterproof, but because it encases the matches, it makes it waterproof. So I used a little aluminum dish from a tea candle. Just some wax that I picked off a candle. You can use a tea candle too, but tea candle wax isn't very good. So I just keep working it, and then I add a little more dryolint. And as soon as it gets wet from the melted wax, it's good to go. It just needs a very small amount of wax. Tea candle wax is terrible. It hardens pretty quickly, but it takes a long time before it hardens solid enough to actually use it. But if you ask your mother, wife, or girlfriend, you can grab some wax from an old candle. You can even use the wick and embed that. Makes it easier to light. And we use the aluminum container and just melt wax right into that. Probably a quarter or less wax, and then the rest is dryolint. This is terrible dryolint, but it's mostly cotton. And cotton is what they use in wicks. It burns really well. Containers, you can use anything, paper cups, paper plates. These are from a pharmacy, which are handy. As you can see, I put a lot of little survival odds and ends in one of these canisters. Old foam canisters work. Use your imagination. You could use a tin, you might have stuff lying around. So I use containers that are the same size. The one container I cut down, I cut it an inch, but it should have been less. And the other containers, the other one I used to press the wax down with, I should have used some cling wrap over that. And then the other container that I used to press the wax down will be the container that'll hold my pellets. There should be about 5 of them. So these are great little fuel tablets and good for starting a fire as well. And they're free. It's easy to scrounge wax. I got wax from a restaurant once. 2 big black bags full. Quite easy to get hold of. The restaurant used they had candles on the table and they used to trim the candles down to put in their candle stands. That's quite easy to get wax free, and then dryer lint is free too. So you can make a bottle of these for your survival kit, bottle for your bug out bag. Use a smaller container and make some that you keep in your bag that you take with you hiking. Or keep it in a little pouch where your water bottle is. I cut the smoothers down very haphazardly, but it works. You might be able to find a little shallow container that works for this. Doesn't need to be perfect. Rubbing it on sandpaper helps. So all you need is some matches and break them down to fit into your container. And little Ziploc bags are handy so you don't get wax all over them. You can buy bags of these little Ziploc bags or little pill pouches. I don't know if you absolutely need them though, but it's a little extra insurance. And you need to cut a piece of striker, put it all in your bag, fold up the bag. That goes in your bottle with your wax pellet. You can put other things in your lighters. You can embed anything you want in your fuel pellet. It's a little bit of a messy affair depending on how good your wax is, how hot it is. Try to keep your pot warm, scoop it straight from the pot into the cup. You want very little wax. Now, I used too much wax in this mixture. I should have taken my time and just slowly added the dryer lint to the wax. But you can squeeze out the excess wax and then just reuse some of it. So I embedded the matches in the middle. Scooped in some more dry lint. This is where you want to cover it with cling wrap and then push down. So what I decided to go with was my smaller cup. I ended up putting a weight on it. I ended up putting it in the freezer. We wait a few minutes. Remove it from the freezer. Here's the pellet with the aluminum covering on it. So the idea was to take the bottle with a little indentation at the bottom and then make multiple pellets that can be stacked. Now it doesn't need to have any indentation, but they should all stack equally. and you'd have it in the actual pearl bottle. And then use a spatula, and while the wax is soft, push a line into it. And then when you break it, you can use half, or you can simply just stack the two together, set it alight, use it to start your fire or to boil your water. Put your pot stand over it and you're done. So what I did is dunked it in some water for you to see. It'll be far more waterproof if you just leave it in one pellet. I just split this in two. It's still waterproof. But if you just leave it as the wax pellet, it'll shrug water way better. And that's basically it. Use whatever container you want. You can experiment with a wicks, mix the match to wicks. It's sizzling and cracking right now. And that's basically it. Well, I hope you liked it. Experiment with this and write a response if you try it, or if you got any new better ideas. It burns for a long time too. Thank you for watching.